Hello and good morning, students. I'm Sudipto, and today I'll tell you a very, very important lesson from your book, Tune Into Grammar, and the name of the chapter is Adverb. Okay? And it is very, very important. It is from your book, chapter 5, and it is for class 8 students. So in this chapter, I'll tell you the definition and the types. It is not only important, it is very, very essential part for any English grammar. Okay, so now let's begin. I'll tell you here what is an adverb, what are the different kinds of adverbs. What are the uses of adverbs here? Okay, you will come to know what you can, how you can use adverb in your own sentences. Okay, so here I will tell you about these features so that you will come to know about adverbs. You know adverbs very well. Next, let's start. Here is the definition of adverb. Adverb is a word which qualifies or modifies a verb, an adjective, or other adverbs. So what is the definition of adverb? Adverb is a word which qualifies or modifies a verb, an adjective, or other adverbs. Okay? So, you have learned that how an adjective modifies noun. So here adverb modifies what? Verb, adjective, and other adverbs also. So always you have to keep this this thing in your mind, so that the definition of adverb will be clear to you. Okay? So it is the definition. Now go to the next page. You have learned that an adverb is a word that qualifies or modifies a verb, an adjective, or other adverbs. For example, he spoke harshly. So here harshly is the adverb which modifies the verb spoke. Here spoke means how he spoke harshly. So harshly is here the adverb. Now, the floor is in the corridor was very slippy. So here very is the adverb, and it is going to modify slippery. So very is slippery is the adjective here. Okay, harshly is also the adverb which is going to modify spoke. So here slippery is modified by very. The girl climbed the ladder quickly, quite slowly, but fell, which here modifies the adverb slow. Now study the table to next the different kind of adverbs which I have created. Now there you can use your own sentence and in your own word. So go to the next. Here is the table. Here in the left hand side, kind of adverbs. In the middle column, it is function, and the last column there is examples. So first is adverbs of time. What is adverbs of time? Adverbs of time tells us when an action occurs and answers the question when. Mona will reach soon. So soon is the adverbs of time. The cat seldom runs. Here seldom is the adverb of time. The shop has closed temporarily. Here temporarily is the adverbs of time. like soon, seldom. Soon is also the adverb of time. It says how Mona will reach. Okay? The seldom is also the adverbs of time. And the shof has closed temporarily. Okay? It is also the adverbs of time. Then adverbs of place tells us where the action occurred and answered the question where. I placed it there. So here there is the adverb of place. Turn right and you will find it. It is adverb of time when. So in the time of adverb of place, we will come to know the answer of where. So turn right or there, here it is the adverb of place. So turn right, right is also the adverb of place. Okay. Next, adverb of manner. Adverb of manner tells us how or in what manner the action was performed and answered the question how. The windows banged violently during the storm. So here violently is the adverb of manner. So it is telling in which force the windows were banged violently. So violently is the adverb of manner. Okay? So it shows the manner of the windows banged. Next, adverb of frequency. It tells us how often an action takes place and answer the question how often. Okay? So here Madhu is always studying in her free time. So here Madhu is always trying in her free time. So here always is the time of frequency. Means how often, how long. It is always is the adverb of frequency. Now, adverb of degree. Adverb of degree tells us or extent of an action or a quality and answer the question how much or to what extent. I strongly believe in this, in his viewpoint. I had almost missed my flight. So here strongly and almost is the adverb of degree. Okay? Strongly is also the adverb of degree. Almost is also the adverb of degree. Now next, adverb of reason. Adverb of reason states the reason for the action and answer the question why. Okay, here the examples are, he therefore surrendered to the police. So here therefore is the adverb of reason. Hence, therefore, and hence he must speak to her before she takes action. So here therefore and hence are the adverbs of reason. Okay? Now, interrogation adverb. Used to ask question. Interrogation means to ask question. Why are you angry? So it is the interrogative adverb. Where are your books? Where are your books? It is the interrogative adverb of place. Okay? So now, relative adverb. Relative adverb joins two clauses or sentences together. Relative clause is the main feature of relative clause to join more than two phrases. Or here I know the house, it is a different clause and he leaves, it is a different sentence. So here where joins two different sentences. It is the main action of relative clause. There must be a reason